here again. If you guys follow me on Twitter or Instagram, you guys might know that I just got back from South Korea last night. So I decided to make a video where I'm just gonna like share with you guys everything about my trip. So here I am right now. But before I get started, if you guys want to see all the places that I went and visited, you guys can go to my Instagram and click on the highlight that has a sun emoji on it, because I forgot to like properly vlog everything, so but check that out instead. And if you guys want to see the advertisement that I saw and passed by during my trip, you guys can go to the highlight next to it. Has a heart with like purple white heart, that emoji on it. And yeah, and additionally, if you guys want to check out all of the stuff that I bought in Korea, you guys can go to my K-pop collection account and go click the highlight with the airplane emoticon on it. But additionally, I'm also going to make a haul video for that, so you guys can check it out instead as well. And without further ado, let's get started with the video. So, my flight to South Korea was on the 13th of June and I arrived in Seoul on the 14th. But like 2 days before my flight, I felt really sick. I was really, really dizzy and I felt like throwing up. And even on the D-Day itself, I was still feeling a bit unwell. But thankfully, by the second day of the trip, I felt a lot better, so I actually enjoyed the trip in general. Yay! Okay, so on the first day, I arrived in Seoul like quite early, but then at 10 or 11 p.m.-ish, I decided to go to Coex Mall. Oh, by the way, I went with my parents to South Korea, and it's basically just the three of us. Okay, so we went to Coex Mall, and since I've been wanting to go to the SM Atrium there, I decided to go there first. There we went to the museum and the SM Town Gift Shop. The museum was really cool. They display all of the SM albums and even the photo cards. There's like one wall that is filled with photo cards. Sadly though, I didn't get to take many pictures there because first, I looked like a mess and I was really tired after a long flight. So basically I'm just enjoying it, just like sightseeing everything there. And then in the SM Town Gift Shop, I of course bought a lot of stuff. And yeah, it's only the first day and I already like shop a lot. After the SM Atrium, we decided to go to the mall, which is downstairs, and I immediately went searching for the panorama screen, I think. Basically, Chewy's ad was on that screen, so I decided to go find it. It took me a while and my parents and I had to ask the staff where the location was, but once we found it was worth it. It was really pretty and I was really happy I get to see that, because I think that's the only Chewy's ad that I saw in Korea besides the ads that was displayed on the subway TV thingy. Yeah, so that was day one. After Coex Mall, we went back to the hotel because we were so tired after the long flight. And then day two, on day two, if I remember correctly, we went to K-Star Road. We went to K-Star Road and also JYP Entertainment. We also get to like, oh, since I went there on the 15th of June, Chewy's birthday ad was still on display, and so I got to take a picture with that. I was really happy because I wanted to go, I actually really wanted to take a picture there. And we actually went there before the building. It's like, yes. So anyways, we also visited the Dunkin' Donuts in front of the JYP Entertainment. We sat there for like a few minutes, maybe an hour. We didn't get to see any idols, like no Stray Kids or Twice or any other idols, But I wasn't really expecting to see anyone or like meet any idols anyways. So after JYP Entertainment, I decided to go to Myeongdong because I wanted to shop. So in Myeongdong, I went shopping for unofficial merchandise and also some official merchandise and albums as well. I wanted to like buy the whole set of 101, but then I was like, I don't think it will fit. So I didn't, and only bought the art book version. And then I came across another SM Town gift shop in Myeongdong, so I decided to visit there as well and buy some stuff again. And then after that, we went back to the hotel. So basically every day, we start our trip of the day at like around 11, which is after breakfast. And then we went back to the hotel around 5 because we didn't want to go home very late, even though it's still like bright outside. It's not even dark yet. But yeah, we went like around 7, it's like the latest, I guess. So anyways, day 3. On the third day, we went to 3 SM Town gift shop. I just remember 3 SM Town gift shop because I was searching for specific things. So yeah, first we went to the Coex one again, and I went to the Sun Cafe there and tried the NCT cupcake. I don't know what like it's called, like the NCT cupcake. It tastes really nice actually, and the decoration, like the hat decoration, was really cute as well. And I get to sit on the red velvet table, the one with the Joy center, because my bias is Joy, so I decided to go sit there. Wanted to sit at the like NCT table, but it was so like messy. There's like lots of stickers on it, so I decided to go sit in the red velvet one instead. After that, so sorry. After that, we went to Dongdaemun. Yeah, we went to Dongdaemun because there's another SM Town gift shop there, and I finally got a new phone case on there. So I bought the black on black one. Sadly, I cannot show you this here, but I have a picture. So yeah, because I'm using my phone to record it. So anyways, I got the black on black one, and I also shopped for like some other stuff as well on that store. And then after Dongdaemun, we decided to go to Myeongdong because it's pretty close, I guess. So we went to Myeongdong and went to the SM Town gift shop again. And there, I bought the NCT collectible. So actually, the day before, like on day 2, I actually saw that they have Kun, Jungwoo, and Mark left. That's like the stock that are left. But since none of the 3 are like my ultimate bias and NCT, I was like, should I buy or not? So I didn't buy it. And then the next day I went, I was like, okay, let's just buy it, whatever. So I decided to buy the Mark NCT collect book. I almost bought the Jungwoo one as well, but didn't. The Kun one was already sold out when I went there the next day, so there was only Jungwoo and Mark, and I decided to buy Mark's. I don't even know why. Maybe because of like I'm a more NCT dream. I don't know. So yeah, that's that. And then we went like around Myeongdong a bit, bought some other stuff, I guess. And then went back to the hotel, and that's day 3. And then the fourth day, we went to some celebrity cafe and the submarket. So it's located in Cheongdam, if I remember correctly. It's located in Cheongdam, and first we went to the submarket first, and I shopped some more there. And then in that building as well, they had the SM dance practice studio. So usually if there's like someone practicing in there, they're gonna like close the curtains and you're just gonna see their shadows or silhouette. But it was empty at that time, so I get to see the room. It was really pretty. Oh my god. And afterwards, we went upstairs again to the boutique cafe and had lunch there. We ordered two food, but the portion was really big, so we decided to take away the leftovers. And after SM Entertainment, we decided to go to JYP Entertainment again because it was pretty near to each other, I guess. So we went to JYP Entertainment, and while we were there, we decided to go to FNC and the old SM Entertainment building as well. So yeah, that's basically. So basically on the fourth day, I just went around to different agencies. Yeah, because after the old SM building, we decided to go to Cube Entertainment, which was quite far from there. We had to take the train again, but it was kind of worth it because in Cube Entertainment they have 20 Space Cafe, and in that cafe they have like a display of, what do you call it? Merchandise and albums of the Cube artists and groups. So yeah, and then tried to like chill there for a while. Also, in 20 Space Cafe, I actually met a quite famous YouTuber. I don't know if you guys know her, but I'm not really met. I saw Soulmate, but I didn't get to approach her because I was shy. And I didn't really want to like disturb her or anything because she was with her friends. Mostly because I was shy, so I'm just like admiring her from far. This sounds so creepy, but okay. So anyways, I think after Cube Entertainment, that's it, and we went back to the hotel. After Cube Entertainment, we decided to go to YMC building. Because I wanted to, and I asked my friend, like, is there like a cafe nearby or anything, or is it just a building? The entertainment, and my friend said that there's a coffee nearby, so like, okay, let's go there. So we went there. It was quite a long walk from the train, but not really like far from the station. It was quite near actually, and we went there and went to the cafe. They were playing 101 song, but like other songs as well, but they played like a few 101 songs. And also, they were playing Zootopia movie, but it was ending already. And the cafe was filled with like 101 stuff. And actually, I met Tejina. He is a trot singer from Korea. And if I remember correctly, I googled it, and Google said that the son of Tejina is actually the owner or like CEO of YMC. So yeah, that's that. And then after that, we went to the line store and shopped for some stuff there as well. And after that, we went back to the hotel. And I think that was like the only day I went back to the hotel at like 7-ish. Yeah. And on day 5, I only go to Lotte World, and that's basically it. Oh gosh, wait. So day 5 is basically only Lotte World. We're only like going there and went to the mall and also went to the adventure park. But I didn't get to ride anything because I wasn't really feeling it anyways. And to be honest, like if I go to an amusement park like that, I would prefer going with friends or at least like with more people than just the three of us. But I get to see the haunted house that 101 went. That house. I almost went inside. I was like, no, I hate haunted house. So like, I don't want to cry or even scream. So I was too scared to go in, and so I didn't. And then I also wanted to go to the Viking one, the ship one, but the line was really long for that ride, and I was like, yeah, I don't want to queue that long, so I didn't ride anything. Only like the train that goes around the park, and that's it. because I was too afraid if I go to a ride, especially the one that goes like around or like up and down, that I was afraid that I would get sick again. So I didn't write anything. So yeah, that's basically day 5. And on the 6th day, day six, we went to Hongdae because Blackpink House was located there. So my friend told me to go there, and since I'm in Korea and Blackpink House is gonna close on the 24th, why not go there while I'm here? So I decided to go to Blackpink House, and we arrived in Hongdae around 12 or 1, and Blackpink House is open at like 4 p.m. Oh, sorry. So Blackpink House opens at 4 p.m. But I got there around 12 or 1, so it was still empty. There was no queue yet, so I decided to take like a few pictures first in front of the door. So anyways, since there was no queue yet and it opens at 4, decided to go somewhere else first, and at around 2 past something, maybe almost 3 o'clock, we went back to the location and there was like a queue already. So my parents and I decided to take turns queuing. So while my dad and I went to a nearby restaurant to eat, my mom is queuing for us. And then we switched places. And then around 3 o'clock, they started to distribute the tickets, like a piece of paper with the time on it. So I got the 4 p.m. slot. And I was actually really thankful so I don't have to wait too long. So I got the 4 p.m. slot and there was like still an hour left. So I decided to go around again and we went to La Biote because new is W. So we shopped there, and when it's almost like 4 p.m. already, we went back to the location and queue again. So Blackpink House is actually really pretty. They played a lot of Blackpink songs in there. Sorry. There's like 4 rooms where you can play. Like, it's for entertainment purpose, I guess. We went upstairs first, and there's this room. So the staff said it was Lisa's room, and I have to act like Lisa. I was taken aback for a few seconds, like, okay. Like, there's this money gun. Yeah. And usually, like, it's Supreme, right? But this one is Blackpink. And so I decided to play with it because I wanted to play with this. So I was playing it. My parents didn't actually record it, I think, but they took pictures. So I played with it and like posed with it. It was so awkward. But the staff was really nice. So I was taking a picture at another location, and one of the staff was hyping me up. It's like, oh yes, girl. It's like, what? But he doesn't really say that, but like he was hyping. So the staff was really nice actually, and they actually speak English really well. So that's really helpful. So there's this another room where you play a remote control car. It was a tank actually, but yeah, you play it and yeah. And you get to take a picture there as well. And then there's this room, this is my favorite room. So basically it was filled with light sticks. And they were blasting like doo-doo-doo, doo-doo-doo. How do you pronounce it? Like doo-doo-doo, da-da-da. So basically they play the Blackpink song, and then the light sticks are reacting to it. It's actually pretty cool. It's like a maze, and I actually recorded it. If you guys want to check it out, you guys can go to my Twitter, or maybe I'm gonna play it here. So yeah, it was really fun. And then there's this last room, which is the punching game. If I remember correctly, my score was like 500 something. And then my dad tried twice and he got 600 something. I don't know if he got to 700, but I think it was 600 something. My mom didn't want to try because like she was like, no. So my dad tried it twice. And afterwards, we went to the stall to like buy some merchandise because my friends actually wanted me to buy something for them. So yeah, we went to that stall, and then there's this like garden where you can write messages to Blackpink. I wrote my message, and then my parents also wrote their messages. And yeah, after that, we went back to the hotel immediately because the next day, on the 7th day, we had to go to the airport quite early because our flight was around 2 o'clock. So yeah. And again at the airport, actually, when I was in the airport already, I heard that 101 was arriving at the airport as well. But I think it was a different terminal because I don't actually find any flight that goes to America. I didn't actually find one flight, but there's like the gate wasn't really that crowded. Or maybe they went to the private lounge, I don't know. I wasn't actually like expecting to see them anyways. But that's actually quite similar to what happened in Singapore. So when I went to MXM in Singapore, when I was in the airport already, I heard that MXM was also arriving at the airport, but a different terminal again. So like, yeah. So yeah, that's basically my trip in Korea. So I only went around Seoul actually because I've been to Korea before, like 2 or 3 years ago, and I felt I got sick at that time. It was really bad. I didn't enjoy the trip at all at that time. But I did get to meet Team Top at that time. Oh. So yeah, I got to meet like Eljo before he left the group. And Eljo is my bias, if you guys didn't know. So even though I was sick, this was like the best part, the highlight of that trip 2 years ago. So yeah, since I went to like Jeju, Nami and stuff already, decided to go to and focus in Seoul and like went around searching for K-pop stuff basically. So yeah, that's for my trip. I'm so sorry guys that I didn't like vlog properly there. I actually wanted to like vlog like vloggers, but I was still so embarrassed to like film myself in public and like talking in public. So I didn't get to do that, and I also forgot to do it actually. So yeah, maybe I'm gonna try to like vlog properly next time. I don't know, I still need to get used to it like. So yeah, you guys have to bear with me talking like narrating everything for now. So yeah, make sure to check out the haul video I'm gonna making as well. If it's uploaded already, I'm gonna link it down somewhere. So yeah, see you guys next time.